And now it's time for Bedtime Stories with...
Ron Burlington!
Ronnie B!
No.
Ronnie!
Hi, y'all.
Yeah.
Hey, y'all, you boys and girls. Today, we're going to read a bedtime story called E.T., the Eccentric Transexual. You know, that's just a great title right there. So, anyways, once upon a time, in some boring town in the Midwest, 1982, there lived a semi-retarded, narcoleptic boy who could barely talk without a horrible, slurpy lisp named Lucas. Now, his problems were all caused by his dad pushing in his soft spot as a baby, using the caved-in infant's head as an ashtray. Also from his father trying to abort him with a coat hanger. Lucas still has horrible scars on his forehead, but luckily for Lucas, his father had committed suicide because he was so ashamed of his ill-mannered son. Now, any fucking ways. One night, Lucas awoke, startled because a high-priced sports car crashed into his bedroom, and it came right through the wall. The high beams wound, but he saw the most beautiful form of a woman stumble out. Now, as the woman slumped closer, the prepubescent boy was startled. Now, make no mistakes, Lucas was dumber than a dried-out piece of dog shit, but he knew the adult female body very well from all the times his mother passed out naked on the bathroom floor. He would do all sorts of nasty things to her. But what startled him about this woman was that she had the thickest appendage finger coming out from between her legs. It flopped back and forth as she came closer, and the tip was all bright red. Dumb little fucker finally spoke to this wonderful lady. "You must be an alien with extra bright fingers so that you have between your toes, legs. Now you must have cracked your spaceship and I'm going to take care of you and nurse you back to health." The alien spoke with slurred words, and Lucas was so happy she spoke English. She said,
"Yes, you dumb little fucker. I am an alien. And my extra finger has been poisoned. You're gonna have to suck the poison out for me, sweetie."
Lucas saw the alien was in pain, so he walked her to his closet, sat her down on a big pile of stuffed animals, and he sucked that magic finger with the bright red tip till his mouth was full of the salty poison. The alien told him he had to swallow it, or his mother would die, and so he did. He felt so great that he helped his visitor, and he fell asleep on his bed, and she fell asleep in his closet. But the next morning, he got dressed, shut his door, shut it tight, ran downstairs, and his mom was a real piece of shit, never left the house, so she wouldn't have even known that spaceship had crashed into the house. He went to school, and when he got home, he ran into his room. The alien was waking up and told him she needed her special alien food from the glove box of the car. Lucas retrieved a bag of white powdered alien food for her. And she was amazed that alien ate by inhaling it up her nose. He then asked, "What's your name, sir? You sexy alien?" The alien spoke again, but this time much faster than the other times. She said,
"I'm E.T., the Eccentric Transvestite. And before I left my home planet, I was poisoned so much that it's still in me. You sucked some of it out last night, but there's no more. There's more and more to get out, and I know that even better way to get it out is in your mouth."
Lucas said of course he'd help her, and she proceeded to put her special finger in his butthole. This time all the poison drained out. Lucas was the happiest boy in the world, and he fell asleep. But in the middle of the night, He was awoken as a SWAT team busted into his bedroom. They screamed at him that he was harboring a tranny fugitive. That boy slurped angrily that they was aliens that poisoned her and told them to stay away. They screamed at him and he was a real retard and that she was a ladyboy who's had a horrible case of genital warts on the head of a huge cock that was wanted for drug and weapon sales and 28 counts of murder. Just then, E.T. awoke, ran to her spaceship and emerged with a machine gun. She started firing at that SWAT team, but they fired back. Lucas ran to E.T. to protect her, and as she did, they were both shot to death instantly. Then the cops, they fucked both E.T. and Lucas's dead corpses, and then they fucked a passed out mother, doused the house with gasoline, burnt it down with all them inside. And that's the end. There isn't any more.